All right, so this week, OpenAI has basically released a new version of the 3.5 turbo model with a context window of 16,000 tokens. What I thought I'd do is just make a video of showing you some of the things that you can and perhaps some of the things you can't do with the 16,000 tokens. Everyone wants large context windows, and yes, they are fantastic, and yes, it's awesome to have this. But I think often people don't realize, okay, what's the best way to use them? What can we just do out of the box straight away? And then what other things that we need to think about a little bit more about how to do? So I'm going to go through two different mini projects to show you one about summarization, which I think is one of the big advantages that you can do with the 16,000 context window. And the second one of trying to get it to write a very long article in this. So let's go through the code and have a look at each of these and see how they work together. All right, in the first example I'm going to look at here, we're going to be looking at summarization. The idea is that we're going to use an LLM chain to basically summarize a long paper from archive here. So just quickly to show you the paper I've got, I've taken the Tree of Thoughts paper, and this is actually a pretty long paper, and it's a pretty dense paper as well in here. So I'm just focusing in this case on basically getting all the tokens and seeing how many tokens there are. And then you're going to see that even this is going to be too long for the 16K tokens. So we're going to split it on this references section here. So let's jump in. So originally I had it so you could just download the paper automatically here. For some reason today, this doesn't seem to be working. I'm getting a forbidden code. My guess is it's probably to do with the IP that Colab has that's hitting it there. So this will probably work on your local computer and sometimes will work on Colab as well, but not currently. So I've just basically downloaded that PDF file and uploaded it in here and set this up here. And that's what this function would normally automatically do. So the first thing we've got to do is basically just extract out the information. So here I'm just using the PyPDF2 PDF reader, and I'm just going for a basic, reading this in. So we can see that the document is 11 pages long. We go through and strip out all the text, and you can see it's definitely a lot of text in there. We've got all the details from the abstract right through each part. And this is what we're going to be interested in getting out of this. So if we count the number of tokens in this, so this is just basically using tick token, and we're using the GPT-3.5 tokenizer to do the counting. So the tokenizer is the same, whether it's the normal size model or the 16K model, there's no difference there. And we're basically getting 17,000 tokens out. So because of that, we're going to have to remove some of these tokens. So I tried around with a few different ways that you can do this. You can go through and just filter out the citations at the end. The challenge with that is that when you've got a paper with a large appendix as well, you'll find that that alone is probably not going to be enough to bring them down. So what I do is just basically split on the references. So it just removes everything after references. So if we do that, and then we look at the tokens, now we're down to just under 15,000 tokens here. So 14,700 tokens here. And this is a good amount to try out and to see, okay, how's this going to go? So I've got some little helper functions there for just looking at this and saving it to a text file at the end. And then we're going to bring in LangChain. So obviously we're using the chat model, right? So we're going to be using the 16K model. So we need to basically use it like a chat model, which means we need to have a system prompt and a human prompt or a user prompt. So setting up the system prompt here, I'm basically trying to, so supposedly the new model for 3.5 is much more steerable. And also with the 4, I think is much more steerable. In the past, the 4 has been okay for using the system prompts, but the 3.5 hasn't really responded to them. So you might want to play around with putting this in this part in the system prompt, or just doubling up and putting it in the human prompt as well here. So here I've basically just put in the system prompt. You're a helpful AI researcher that specializes in analyzing ML, AI, and LLM papers. Please use all your expertise to approach this task. Output your content in markdown format and include titles where relevant. So this is just setting up the context of this. And then the human prompt is actually going to give it what we want it to do. And in this case, it's going to be, please summarize this paper, focusing on the key important takeaway for each section, expand the summary on methods so that they can clearly be understood. And then we're going to pass in the paper content in here. So once we've got these two set up, we basically just want to make our chat prompt template from the system prompt with the human, so system message and human message in there. We set up our LLM. Here we're basically doing, you know, we're using the Turbo 16K model. Obviously, this is what this is all about. Play around with the temperature. I've gone for a temperature of 0.2 because I was using this for some other tasks as well earlier. You could even just bring it right down to zero and see how that goes. We then basically set up our summary chain. We're here, I'm just going to do a straight chain. So this is not normally in the past, the setting up a summarizer chain or something, we'd have to think about, are we able to stuff it all in? Are we going to have to do map reduce? Are we going to have to do things like that? In this case, the whole idea is that we're trying to fit it all in one pass and do the whole thing in one pass. So once we've got that done, once we've got our summary chain done, we can basically just run it through. And here I'm going to basically just using the Git OpenAI callback for counting tokens. And then I've just put in the new costings in there to basically cost out how much this would be. You can see that we passed in 14,867 tokens. So that was the paper plus our prompts. And we got back 438 tokens for this. Now, this is the kind of example that I think where the 16K tokens shines, is where you've got something long that you want to pass in and you don't need your output to necessarily be long. You're trying to reduce, you know, the output here. I'll show you a sort of counter example of this later on, of where this sort of model and this 16K context doesn't really help you that much. So anyway, this has basically gone through. It cost us 4.6 cents for doing that, for do that whole summary. And we can see that if we basically look at the summary, we've now got a summarization out for this. Let me just bring in, so this is basically just saving it to a text file. Okay, here's the text file that we have saved out. And you can see it's gone through the abstract, the introduction, it's gone through each of the parts and given us a basic summary. Now, I certainly wouldn't claim that this prompt that I've put in here is the best prompt for this. I would encourage you to, you know, go through and experiment with different prompts for the style of summary that you want. But it has been able to work out things like the related works and stuff like that. Don't forget, it doesn't have the citations, so it's not going to cite actual other papers or something like that. But it gives us a nice sense about what the paper is about and some of the background to this, and then some of the experiments that they ran. So we know that with this paper, they basically tested it on three different kinds of experiments or kinds of games to play in here, one being a number game, one being the crossword, and the third one being the creative writing here. So this is showing you basically just doing a simple summarization example where we've made use of the really long context. We've done it in one pass and we've basically used 15,300 tokens for doing this. Okay, in this next example, we're going to look at trying to write a really long article here. And this is going to show you that often the 16K tokens are not going to be useful as easily as you think they will be. So the goal here is to basically give it a topic and have it write 5,000 words on this topic. And you're going to see that it doesn't work the way we would expect that it would work. So, okay, I've got some simple utility functions there that we were using before in some of the other ones. Again, we're basically doing this very similar to the first one. So we're bringing in the LangChain various prompts for the chat model. We're obviously using the chat OpenAI model here. And you can see here that we're starting off with a prompt of where we're saying you're a master writer that specializes in creating long 5,000 word articles. Please use all your expertise to approach this task. Output your content in markdown format and include titles and subtitles where relevant. And so the first example is we're going to just try and get it to just write. And if we just try to get it to write, that it will still just do a very sort of normal length. It doesn't really listen or pay attention to when you tell it a long 5,000 word article. So one of the tricks that you can do some of the time is to basically get it to generate chunks of data. And actually, this is how you would normally do it with a shorter context. You generate various chunks of data, and then you just basically stick them all together. So here we can try and do it in one prompt or one pass, where I basically say, okay, please generate 15 questions. The questions would be that, you know, what the topic is about, and allow you to flesh out each of these questions into a 500 word answer. So technically, if it did that, we should get 7,500 words back. And we can basically see that it's going to take in the description. And then I've got a bit about that it should use each of these questions for writing a main title, a subtitle, and then answering each of these. Now, if we go through and we pass in the topic is the pros and cons of regulating AI research and development. We run this through the chain, and you're going to see that it didn't use many tokens at all. There was no real reason why this needed to be. You can see we were using the 16K token model, but there was no reason for us to use that. So we actually wasted money by using this one rather than the cheaper model. And the reason is that it just doesn't elaborate on these things. You'll see that with the output that it's put out here, we've only got 903 tokens. So we're looking at 500-600 words max for this kind of thing. So just asking it to generate a really long output out tends to not work. And this is where there's a little bit of controversy of like, how are OpenAI actually doing this 16K window? Are they doing it in a way where it's really paying attention to, you know, everything in there? Or is it some kind of hack that they're doing here? I'm not sure about that. When we try it with longer things, it does seem to pay attention to some things, or it seems to me usually pays attention to a lot of things, but I'm not sure it's actually able to attend over every single fact in there. So if we were putting in 15,000 tokens in, like the first example, I'm not sure how well that actually is coming out or not with the attention there. And this is one of the problems with the story writer. If you think back to the MPT story writer 65K token length one there, that because they were using Alibi, really, it was decent at taking a long context in and attending to, I'm not even going to say most of it, attending to a large amount of it, but there's probably hasn't been enough testing to see how well does it attend to things at the start, the middle, the end, as we go through with that. The same with that model too, is that when I would generate things out of it, at best I could get 8,000 tokens, but often even after 5,000 tokens of generation out, with like a small amount in and aiming for a large amount out, like we're trying to do here, actually after a certain number of tokens, it would sort of just go into gibberish. And I think that that sort of shows one of the common things with some of these models where really, even though you've got a huge context length, it's made more for putting a lot of things in and then predicting a normal amount out rather than generating a whole bunch out. Anyway, so this example, we can play around with this and we can try doing a few different things. So one of the things that we can do is that we could generate the questions first. And so we can generate the questions here. And you'll see that I've gone back to the smaller model to generate the questions because I know that's not going to be more than 4,000 tokens. And sure enough, the amount for that, actually, this is using the 16K calculation. So don't worry about that. But you can see this is obviously a lot cheaper than what it would be if we were using the 16K model there. And you can see from that, we get a set of 15 questions out. Now, we can actually then pass those questions in to try and get this to write a longer context here. Okay, once we've got the questions done, we can then basically pass them into a new prompt that or a new chain that's going to be for generating the actual article. So you can see here, this is basically going to say, please take in the questions and generate out the article here. Again, you should play around with the prompts for this. Now we're using the longer context model. So ideally, we're aiming for sort of 5,000 words out. You'll see that we don't get anywhere near that. Here we're getting a total of 1248 tokens out. We can see that it hasn't cost us that much because it really hasn't generated that much. And if we look at the quality of it, we've got quality that's okay coming out here. The challenge is it just hasn't produced the length that we wanted from this. So the next step that you could do for this, and this is kind of where you would make use of more the long context in via a memory sort of thing, is you would split the questions up, and each time you would get it just to answer one question as you go through. That's, you know, a quite common technique that people have used with the smaller models for this. So hopefully there it's going to benefit from the fact that it can see the previous answers to other questions as well, and that it's just going to continue one question at a time. That's going to be a lot more expensive though, because you're going to be passing this in multiple times. You're not just doing one shot pass through for this. So this is an example, I would say, where the 16K doesn't act like we'd want it to. We then have to think about different prompts and different systems to be able to generate a longer article like we want to do this. This is a common thing for when we're doing the autonomous agents as well. If we want it to generate code, if we want it to do something like that, we're best to get them to focus on small amounts of outputs and generate, you know, multiple generations. So I would suggest the way to use the 16K model is more for long inputs where you want to basically generate a small amount of text or a medium amount of text out, rather than go for trying to generate out 15,000 tokens. That just tends to be very difficult with this. And if some people have got some examples of doing it, I'd love to see. My guess is that there are probably some prompts that will generate out a lot, but on the whole, it's going to be much harder to do than the other way around. Anyway, as always, if you've got questions, please put them in the comments below. If you found this useful, please click like and subscribe. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.